irrelevant.
You ready to fight? Ready.
All right, so here's Stipe Miocic back on the horse here tonight, and certainly has the wrestling chops if he wants to lean on those. But Stipe believed that this is going to be a kickboxing match here tonight. He believes he has the striking advantage, both in terms of the speed and the power. And if he can get that lead foot on the outside, he believes it's going to be a long night here for his heavyweight opponent. That strike blocked by Aspinall. Right lands. All right, nice takedown there by the more well-rounded fighter, and not much resistance from the boxer on that attempt.
Well, the level change is so strong. He went from upright to down in his wrestling stance so quick that it was hard for the boxer to respond. It was perfect. The timing was as good as it's going to be inside the octagon.
Pretty strong jab there by Aspinall. Nice. Nicely done.
Back. Now he's got to start trying to drag him to the ground. Then he can look for submission.
Jeez, you can hear that.
Oh, crippling knee to the body.
Oh, nice. Nice.
Oh, stuffs the takedown without issue. Aspinall's lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling. Oh, and he goes to the hook. Now it's good.
It won't take many of those. Big double leg, double change.
Miocic gets back up again. We have crossed the midpoint here in our opening round.
Nice, solid punch in the head.
Punches in bunches as he lands another combination there. Really doing a nice job stringing his shots together.
He's doing a great job of stringing the shots together and also just mixing up the target and the attacks. Great job finding different places for his strikes to land. Watch our ball here.
Ooh, that looks wicked tight.
It's getting tight now. He's advancing.
Oh, what a transition to the belly down on ball now.
But it's much better than where he was before. Great submission defense.
And he's able to work his way back to his feet. Oh, strike attempt to the midsection is blocked. Under 2 minutes now to go in round one. Strike lands there and not going to help the strike upstairs.
I love this accuracy, this ability to get his shots to the target right away. And you see it in the swelling that is forming on his opponent's face.
Shooter throw. Let's see if he can capitalize and lock up a sub.
You got to try to find whether or not you're going to land ground and pound here or if you're going to go to a submission.
Miocic gets up, he is back on the feet. Looked like he was in a submissive state on the ground, but he worked hard there to get back to the feet. Strike lands clean. Miocic is now dealing with a cheek cut. Under a minute to go.
Nice punch to the head. Another big
kick. Oh, and transitions right into side control. Aspinall's got the full mount. Really good job with the ground and pound, and now you can see some visible swelling on his opponent.
Now he's got good body position, yup.
Postures up and lands a brutal strike to the head. trying to pound his opponent's head through the canvas. The horn sounds for the end of round one. Archer, that's the end of the round. Potential adversity. Archer, there's the horn. Let us now look back at some of the action in that round, DC, and he had his takedown game going early and often.
Yeah, he had it going great. I mean, he did a great job of finding his entries, rushing to his finishes before his opponent could react and defend him. He should be very proud of the work he did over the course of that last round.
You ready to fight? Ready.
All right, let's get to round two. All right, next round is now underway. Hopefully the action continues at a high level. Pretty good first 5 minutes.
Pretty good first 5 minutes. Both of them can really pick it up. Let's see who decides they're going to lead the dance as we go forward.
Oh, big head kick there. Look at the punch there by Espinal. As he lands another one, he's keeping.
Look at him, he's setting up a choke now. Look at that, he's setting it up. That guillotine choke is getting tight, but you can't just squeeze. You gotta get your hips into your opponent if you want him to tap.
He might get a finish here. Oh, he got out.
Oh, he got out. He did a great job. He attacked a lot. He got pressure forward, then off to the side, rolling his back to release that pressure.
Excellent ground and pound there by the heavyweight Miocic. Trying to pass the guard here, but a nice job by the bottom fighter defensive.
Bottom fighter did a fantastic job of following with his hips, making sure he blocked any attempt to get past his guard. Nice defense.
Arm triangle attempt here.
Nice arm triangle setup.
Ooh, arm triangle's in tight.
It's getting in very tight.
Oh, he escapes.
He got up. Wow, that is great submission defense.
Oh, is he an active pursuer of the submission?
Now he's trying to guillotine.
Oh, that gilly is tight.
What a great job attacking the lock, rolling to your back, giving up the mount. He chose a much worse position over giving up that submission.
This is some exhausting work, man.
I mean, it is so tiring to be fighting in this way. So much wrestling, so much grappling, expending all this energy trying to hold the guy down. I mean, no takedown is not fought. No reversal is not fought. Everything they're doing is fought to the very last minute before it gets given up.
Well, this fight's been pretty crazy thus far. Both guys doling out a lot of damage, and neither seems too bothered by it, but clearly both parties are hurt.
Both guys are hurt. Both guys are fighting beautifully. Both are showing a lot of heart right now in this fight. They're both doing amazing jobs. Let's see who gets the job done at the end of this thing.
Aspinall going for the takedown. He misses. Man, has he landed a high volume of strikes here in round.
Oh, my goodness. That guillotine is tight.
Postures up now and lands a vicious head strike. Miocic is in half guard. These ground strikes are really starting to add up. There's another one. A lot of top pressure being applied here. Oh, and he escapes up to his feet. Very nice. Oh, brilliant execution to land the roundhouse. Miocic's eye is closing up. Separation. Oh! Massive kick to the head. Well, he just hasn't been efficient with his strikes here tonight. There's another swing and a miss, and at this point, if he can't preserve some stamina moving forward, this is going to end up being an awfully long night. All right, so he continues to land a high volume.
He has to evade Stan's face.
Stipe's head kick is blocked, so no damage inflicted there. And there's the single. Miocic has got his hand looking for a guillotine. Ooh, that's tight. Might just be a matter of time now. Oh, submission. submission defense on full display there.
He said that he was very aware of what this guy brought to the octagon and the show in that defense.
Work, come on, stand it up, it's work.
Man, submission defense is a powerful thing. Offense keeps going for it. Defenders held up every step of the way.
Yeah, the defense has done a great job just making sure he leaves nothing long, no submission attempts. Even when they get him, he continues to stay calm and patient, and he's defending these submissions.
Aspinall's tough as it gets with that mouth.
He's hurt.
Corner now, and we will keep a close eye on things. Aspinall's eye is looking pretty bad at this point, DC. The cup man's gonna hustle in there and see if he can work on that, or that eye might swell shut. All right, so back to the stools we go. They say defense wins championships, and he has not defended well tonight.
He isn't trying, or at least it doesn't seem like he's trying. He has got to move his head. He's trying to react when the punch is already coming, and that's not working. If he takes many more of these shots, this fight is going to be stopped due to the swell.
Ready to fight? Ready.
Third round underway. Well, you didn't see a lot of the body work from him in the earlier rounds, but he's certainly getting after it here. Big shot to the body connects there. We'll see if he can follow it up. So pretty good recovery by the opponent after getting stunned pretty good. Got to capitalize on those opportunities.
I mean, you can't waste these opportunities. You don't get them as often as you'd like. So if you get a guy hurt, you got to find a way to finish the fight. Oh, he's got his back. He's got to get him in the air to try to return him to the mat.
Big power shot there.
Nice block.
Aspinall's eye is now swollen shut. They could actually stop this fight right now, given how bad it is. Clearly, the referee keeping a close eye on the fight. Swing and a miss with that punch by the heavyweight Miocic. Tries to work it into a takedown. All right, so maybe he goes for another takedown here, and it's the setups too, right? He's not blindly shooting from the outside. All right, breaking the action here. No surprise to see the referee call for the doctor to look at that eye, which is essentially swollen shut at this point.
Yeah, it's swollen shut. I mean, the inswell is not working. Sometimes the swelling is too much, and you have to save the fighter from himself.
Looks as though the doctor is going to allow the fight to continue. For the athlete, may want to raise the guard a little bit.
He's got to raise the guard. He's got to take some chances because he's very limited in what he can do right now with that much swelling.
All right, well, this fighter was bullish in his desire to continue, and the doctor is going to afford him that opportunity as the referee gets us back underway.
This guy's a fighter, man. This guy doesn't want to lose a fight on the stool. He wants an opportunity to go out there and go out on the shield. And that's exactly what he's getting. He's getting a chance, and as a fighter, that's all you can ask for.
And you know fans don't like doctor stoppages, so they are thrilled.
They start booing. And sometimes guy's eye is hanging off the side of his head.
Oh, man, look how quickly he gets that foot to the target. And he caught the kick. Under 3 minutes now to go on the round.
The fighters separate. Take it for a ride. Nice double look. Nice finish.
All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC. All right, he continues to bully his opponent here, really manhandling him on the ground. It's all pace and pressure down the stretch. He is really lighting him up now. Well, when you absorb damage like this, you start to worry about a guy missing the rest of the year. At what point, if you're the referee, do you call in the ringside physician?
Well, right now.
Yeah.
I feel like a little bitical. You could have called in the ringside physician, and no one would have cared because you look at him and you see that he has been thoroughly beaten, and tonight is just not his night.
Under 2 minutes to go in the round. Takedown defense holds up. Fighters separate from the clinch. Well, he's doing a nice job here blocking these shots. The chin is tucked, the hands are high. Pretty good job defensively thus far.
Great job defensively. He's seeing everything coming.
Oh, lands another.
Oh,
big diving punch lands up top. Well, hard to win fights in mixed martial arts from the bottom, but nice work here in that position by Aspinall. Herb Dean calls for the stand up there.
Right. Stop.
Well, MMA is a constant exercise in risk mitigation, right? But it would seem to me that if he really goes for it offensively, you get him out of there.
Well, he's got him hurt. He's got him hurt multiple times in one round. It looks like this fight should be over by now, but his opponent's still standing, and I think that speaks to the durability of the guy standing in front of him.
All right, so at this point, maybe the ringside physician will indeed call the fight referee, bringing him in to look at that damage.
Got to save the athlete from themselves. Too much damage. Stop the fight, ref.
Nah, it's going to do it. Unfortunate end to the fight, but he's not going to pass any vision test with that eye.
No, absolutely. And he's upset right now. But as time passes, he'll get over it and realize that he lives to fight another day.
All right, here's Bruce Buffer now with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, the doctor has called a stop to this fight, declaring the winner by TKO, Stipe Miocic.
All right, so there he is, the Croatian-American Stipe Miocic, one of the greatest heavyweights of all time, and a familiar sight to see him get his hand raised there in the octagon.
I mean, he's a phenomenal fighter, great boxing, great toughness. They talk about Cleveland tough. Stipe Miocic is the definition of Cleveland tough, and he gets the job done tonight.